This is also a contemporary labyrinth. It's called the Santa Rosa design. A friend of mine came up with that pattern in 1997. And it is similar to some of the cathedral labyrinths. If you're familiar with Chartres Cathedral, it's quartered. And this, again, you can walk with your hand. So, this is small enough. You can put it on a bedspread or a tabletop, so it can be used by people that maybe aren't able to walk at the time. And it rolls up. It's what I call my nomadic art. Because some of you know, I lived a rather nomadic life for a few years. So that's how some of this evolved. So I can take this with me wherever I go. This is a design that I originated, and it's called the North Star Labyrinth. It is a five-circuit labyrinth, and I painted the stars on it so that the Polaris, the North Star, would be right in the center. And this is Cassiopeia down here, and you can see that I've got tape where I'm going to be painting other things, and the Big Dipper is that end. So this pattern is in the Hennepin County Medical Center in their chapel, and it's tile laid into the floor. And now it's been laid on the ground in stone at the Point Arena Lighthouse in California on the Mendocino Coast. So that would be flagstone pathways and large enough for visitors to walk. This labyrinth is an old design with its origins here in the United States. It's one of the Hopi labyrinth designs called the Round Form and Mother Earth Labyrinth. And I have painted stars, seven stars on it, representing the star cluster of the Pleiades, which is important to the Hopi. When they are viewed through the smoke hole in the kiva, it signals the beginning of the storytelling season and when they open and inviting the chance. So I'll demonstrate with this one how to walk the labyrinth. And somebody asked me one time what I did, and I said, I make art to walk it. So I usually take my shoes off if I'm walking the canvas. And I pause at the entrance and I ask myself, what do I lay down? What burden or thing do I need to put aside for a moment? And I guess I'll literally lay this down. And then I ask a question, and sometimes I just say, what is there for me to know? Or I might walk with a gratitude